Hi, how are you?
There's one other person in the elevator, and she's talking about tomorrow, and he goes, it's a sex thing.
Yeah. He always says stuff to embarrass people. So there's this guy standing in the elevator.
One person in the elevator.
It's like us three and that guy, and he looks at the guy, and he's like, it's a sex thing. The guy's just like...
But you two know him. You two know him good enough to know that he's in a polis.
Kind of, you know, I haven't really hung around with him for 13 years.
Yep.
Right.
And then really
Well, just tell me. I'll just
We should do a lot of that before the wedding.
Down,
just
hang out in the back.
Yeah.
Well,
just put
them
in the
stairs.
Right.
Yeah.
So I separated all the
stairs.
I'm
just
reserved seating.
Yep. It literally has the name on it. So when you get there tomorrow, you should probably just go upstairs, both of you guys, and just see, like, on the chairs, it'll say who's supposed to sit where, as far as our.
It's all fine and dandy if you know who they are.
Right, well, that's.
It's a group.
I can help, yeah.
I was gonna say, there's a little communication, asking who they are. Don't be embarrassed.
So, you know, like, well, we're just those certain runs, I don't know.
For immediate family, yes.
Okay, but the rest of us.
But no, the rest is.
So you're gonna escort, Jennifer's grandparents.
Okay, so I'm just gonna walk next to them, basically, right side, left side, doesn't matter.
Well, but like I said, no, oh, watching.
Cause they're gonna escort.
Yeah, so you would walk my grandma up, arm with my grandpa walking.
Or you can escort each other.
I think he prefers.
Why is he gonna be treated like a birthday?
Oh, that's Cal and me, so he's walking up Cal and me.
You remember this stuff.
Cause I was going totally, I'm going. You know, I was thinking one second. You know my name?
No, I don't.
Would you like to know my name?
No.
You want to be my friend.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, cause you can say wrong.
Rule number one.
And then you're gonna go next with Jeff's dad, and then you're gonna come back and have a seat in the back, and then you're gonna go again, and you're gonna bring your mom.
Yep.
And then you're gonna seat your mom, and then you're gonna.
Remember, because you have to point your eyes.
Okay? Okay. Any questions, ushers, right now?
Okay, so is that all we're, okay, after we usher them, then we usher the rest of the people, or no?
No, they're already seated.
So we release people.
Okay, when they, when first you just go up to the row, and all, you know, see them coming out.
I kind of pictured. And don't get me wrong, I picture like at Amanda's wedding, where the ushers were there, the people, you know, kind of at the end of the aisle, the people come up, you do ask them.
Point which side do they go to?
Well, you ask them if they're family, because we want to try to seat, we have a few rows of reserve. You can't pick out like immediate family, so just if they see their family, sit them towards the front. You know, until it fills up, and then just.
And really, and I'm just gonna be, or however you guys did it.
Right, I don't think that'll work, because, you know, they're not gonna come in the right order, right?
Okay, it's just like any other wedding, you're gonna have programs, you're gonna be standing in the front.
Cause these two girls are gonna.
You're gonna actually come downstairs at that time.
Yep.
There's so much more stubborn than that, that just does not.
So, as you do that, you know what? You can go, or we can have people, do you want them upstairs, Jen? Would you rather have them, and we're sure.
Yes.
And then we're sure, okay, so we'll see them upstairs, you know, you'll have programs, you know, to ask them, see if you can take them, you know, and show them where they need to go. It's just something that it works itself. People have been doing enough weddings, I don't know how to explain it, but it really does.
And then we have like a reserve.
Yeah, you can always curl up.
But this actually does kind of go right.
You guys.
Where the seating is.
And so.
Right.
You know what I'm saying, you're not gonna walk up to go like this. You're gonna kind of, cause you're coming up the stairs, and the seating will start really kind of where the stairs are.
So, we are seeing them from the outside.
Yep, well, you know what, you can kind of walk them towards the middle, and then, you know, bring them down. You know, you're kind of going the opposite direction because you have to. Normally, you walk in the back of the church, you're actually walking in the front of the church, how we look at it. But, you see what I'm saying? Because this is the head, and you're right.
And you can see it tomorrow.
You know, when you guys come tomorrow and they're not, and
they're gonna be early.
Okay, I'm there at 1, okay? So when you guys come over, I think we kind of do a walk to show you guys are comfortable. We're just, I don't want to make a mountain out of a molehill. It's
just getting people to sit down.
Well, just you three will get together.
And that's, you know, and where it comes to the wire, when people don't want to sit at the end, you're like, get them upstairs, come on. Thing that's starting at 5:30.
I just want to add one more thing. I do have like the programs in a basket, and I planned on those two girls handing them out. So you don't even have to worry about the programs.
Oh, when they're coming in?
They can just like throw them at people.
You just got released on one of the checks. What about the guy?
So at the end,
at the end of the ceremony, what's going to happen is the everyone's going to exit except me. I'm going to be standing up there. I have an announcement to the guests. Okay. I mean, the bridal party's going to exit. Okay. I'm going to be standing up there. I have an announcement for the guests. And after I am done with my announcement, I'm going to come and shake the parents' hand. So I'll come and shake your hand, and I'll come and shake your hand, and then I'll go and shake Jeff's dad's hand. And after I shake your hands, then you are going to walk down the aisle. And you're actually going to join Jennifer and Jeff in their receiving line downstairs.
So that we can get them.
And then after I walk out, I'm going to follow the parents out, and that's when you are going to come up and start releasing.
From the center aisle and release them all, right?
Yeah.
Is the reception line going to be away from the stage?
Every other side.
Okay. You guys good with that?
Because there was the people stacked up on the stairs.
Yeah.
Is this the worst thing? I don't know. Right.
Well, as long as they release some kind of
stuff, I don't want these guys. All right, wedding party. Sorry. Hope you guys had fun catching up while we were discussing ushers.
We see each other almost every day.
Well,
every couple weeks.
Okay. All right. So I'm going to be, after the family members are seated, I'm going to walk in, then we're going to have Jeff walk in, and then, tell me how to say this again, Jeff, you need to wait until Jeff is all the way up at the front standing with me before you walk in.
Okay.
Okay? After you start to walk in, then we're going to go, when the person in front of you gets halfway up the aisle, then the next person is going to walk in, then the next person, and the next person. Okay?
Walk real fast.
No, and you don't have to, unless you want to, you don't have to do like a special walk or anything, you just walk casually.
Sprinting up the aisle.
You know, walk casually up the aisle. It's pretty. It seems like a pretty long aisle, so
yeah.
It
I just want to see how. I want to see.
So we have
up
to walk
front
by ourselves.
I'm here.
Yeah. I'll be out of breath, man.
What's the attitude about
it?
They were never doing anything.
Oh,
yeah. Here.
You want Peter to take you on, and then you can show yourself
in here. All right, and then you're in the way back with your dad. Okay. We're gonna line up right here, right in front of the waist.
Normally do kind of stop.
Pause.
Yep, pause, and then
you
want to go. Yep,
okay.
Mm-hmm.
Later. Okay.
Now, is this right that he's on my side? That works to my right. You're going to take a step.
Are you guys
but you two will go that fast.
Yeah.
Oh.
No.
Okay, then you're going to sit, because we're going to have reserved seating for you guys.
Yeah. So, don't, like,
they know what they're doing.
I say please rise, and that's the cue. When I say please rise, that's your cue that you can start.
Is this correct that she'd be at my right side to hand off? Or does it make any difference?
Yeah, she's got her right arm through your left. Right? There we go. Yeah. Okay.
This is the right arm.
Yes, that's correct.
I was going to say.
Yeah.
I had to turn around.
Yeah, I can't.
So you guys can turn in. So they're going to stop. Okay, and you're going to stop right at the first.
first row of chairs. There we go. All right, and then Jeff, you're going to step forward. Here we go. And then you guys can hug, shake hands, whatever you'd like to do. And then you can hug your dad. Okay.
Give him a big smoochie.
And then you're going to take Jennifer's hand, and you're just going to give her hand to Jeff. And she's going to just do a little dance. She's going to come right up here and stand with him. Probably the other hand. We need the other hand. Can you come back here? Yeah.
Alright,
you guys
can
shake hands,
so,
and then we hug. Yep, hug.
Okay.
And then I gotta give you a left hand.
Oh, it's gonna be the, oh, it's gonna be the other
hand. Right hand?
Yeah, there you go.
This
there you
one?
Go.
Because
turn
that
around.
We can just,
because your left has the blue.
Like
yeah.
This.
There we go.
I got
it. Let's try it again. Alright.
Oh, that's right. My bouquet.
Yeah, your left has the
yeah. Okay. Oh, because my bouquet is over here.
Yes.
And it is heavy.
Oh, on your left?
Yes.
Okay.
That's why you got that one off.
Okay. So we've hugged, and then you take my right hand.
And you just give
and then you come around here.
And you're just gonna
we do this.
Except
you have
okay.
You gotta
get
rid of
it. And I'm gonna have you stay in place until Jennifer is here.
He is ready.
And then you can walk. And the reason is so when she's moving, you don't accidentally step on her arms.
Oh
okay.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's really, really big.
Yeah. Okay. Real. Yeah.
Yep. And so when she's here, then you can go ahead and have some food.
Okay.
So thanks so much. Okay. And you two, maybe you're good. You can stand wherever you want. Okay. All right. So and then when you are up here, then I say please be seated. Thank you. May be seated, and the rest of your guests will sit down, and then we'll start. Okay. Okay. So this is how this is going to work. I'm going to read an introduction, and then I have a history of Jennifer and Jeff. I'm going to share with everybody. And then we have our first reading, and so at this time Jennifer and Jeff would like to invite Amanda to share a reading. So Amanda's going to come on up, and we're not quite sure where the microphone's going to be yet. It's somewhere off to the, one of the sides of the party. Okay?
Do you want me to actually do it?
You can if you want. You don't have to. Okay.
You Jenny, do you want me to do it?
No,
I can
fine.
Do it if you want.
It's fine. Okay.
Have you heard it?
I haven't, yeah, read it. Okay. Foundations of marriage. Love, trust, and forgiveness are the foundations of marriage. In marriage, many days will bring happiness, while other days may be sad. But together, two hearts can overcome everything. In marriage, all of the moments won't be exciting or romantic, and sometimes worries and anxiety will be overwhelming. But together, two hearts that accept will find comfort together. Recollections of past joys, pains, and shared feelings will be the glue that holds everything together during even the worst and most insecure moments. Reaching out to each other as a friend and becoming the confidant and companion that the other one needs is the true magic and beauty of two people together. It's inspiring in each other a dream or a feeling, and having faith in each other and not giving up, even when all the odds say to quit. It's allowing each other to be vulnerable, to be himself or herself, even when the opinions or thoughts aren't in total agreement or exactly what you'd like them to be. It's getting involved and showing interest in each other, really listening and being available, the way any best friend should be. Exactly three things need to be remembered in a marriage if it is to be a mutual bond of sharing, caring, and loving throughout life. Love, trust, and forgiveness.
Beautiful. Okay, and then you can go sit down. I'm going to fix your wedding party here.
Yes.
So please, just for a second, and then you guys can go back to relaxing. But so I'm going to have you move in a little bit here. So you guys are, we're going to kind of make a little bit of an angle here, just like this. You're kind of going to stand right off the shoulder of the person in front of you. Okay? And then typically, groomsmen, you do right hand over left hand, and just right like this. Okay? And that just makes it look nice for the photos. So, Pepsi over beer. That's how that works. And then on this side, the two are going to step out. We're going to make kind of just an angle here. You're going to stand off the shoulder of the person in front of you. Yep, you might be.
Are we facing this way?
That's what I want to know.
Are you facing this way? Like this? Yep, you're facing Jennifer.
Do you know what I'm. Oh, they just seem like.
Don't follow these clowns. Yeah. Do what you're supposed to do.
And then typically, you want to hold it. Like, I don't know what your bouquets are like. Are they long stem or short?
Sure.
So we hold, you say to hold it at the belly button, right? So you don't want to be like up here, right? You just kind of want a relaxed posture. And then also we just turn one foot out just a little bit. To make it look nice and symmetrical for
us. Right over left, right?
Right over left.
Yeah.
By the way, babe.
Right
over there. Just like the way.
Okay.
Yeah. It's because you're left-handed, so everything's
all right. So
I know,
thank you for doing that. So now after Amanda goes and sits down, I read Reasons for Marriage that Jennifer and Jeff wrote for each other, but they haven't heard yet. So they're going to tell us on the first time on their wedding day. And that's going to be really special, so you might want to bring some tissues. That'll be nice. And then after I read their Reasons for Marriage, we're going to invite Allie up. So at this time, the couple would like to invite Allie to share a reading. So wherever that mic is, it's probably going to be off to the side of the bride and party somewhere.
Yeah,
so you would actually be standing in front, just so you know, on the day, you're going to be standing kind of off to the side somewhere. Yeah. Yep. Okay.
I was asking Julie when I come in, because I have to sit back there with Jenny, but I also have to then be in the front, so she said just wait until Jenny goes up.
Yeah.
And then I just kind of sneak
and maybe if
the
you
side.
Sneak up the side, you're like
she's
right
the
there.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Hand.
Yeah. So then you can sneak up the side and then you'll be right there.
Yeah, that'd be good.
You could probably just hide under my dress, though.
You'd have me laughing all the way. That'd be fun.
Today, I look into the eyes of my best friend, the one with whom I can share anything with. My deepest hopes and heartfelt dreams, inner fears and sheltered insecurities, my most warming joys and overwhelming triumphs. All future journeys that I have left to encounter, this and more I know I can share with you. Today, I take pride in my best friend. With admiration, I look upon you and smile. For all that you are and all that you do makes me so proud. Every part of you that I have come to adore, and for all those parts I have not yet learned. I will live each day from now on, cherishing you with honor. Today, I share my soul to my best friend, my most prized possession, which no other has been given. I give it with great confidence and trust, because with you I am at peace, and I know with you it is safe. You give to me a warmth that I keep with me always, and what else can I give to someone who has given me so much? For you I have opened my eyes to see a love which before you I was blind to. Today I am marrying my best friend, for I know God put you here to be my partner, knowing even before I that you were the one I would live to love, guiding me to this aisle. He knew your hand would be waiting here for me to hold, graciously leading me here to you and allowing us to share this moment together, so I could begin the rest of my journeys through life happily ever after with you, my best friend.
Thank you. Thanks.
Okay. All right, then we do the intent. So Jennifer and Jeff are doing a guest intent, which means that I'm going to ask the guests to stand up, and then I'm going to ask them if they will support Jennifer and Jeff in their marriage, and they are going to respond with, "We will," and then they're going to be seated again. And then I'm going to say, "Jennifer and Jeff, please join your hands so you may feel the gift that you are to one another." And that's the cue that she's going to pass her flowers off. Okay, and we'll go through the reading. I'll say the reading before the intent, and then I will ask you, if you want to marry Jennifer, you're going to say, "I do." Do you want to marry Jennifer?
You better remind
him
that
one. Sure. All right. And then we're going to do the vows, and you're going to go first. Jeff.
Okay.
Yeah. And then Jennifer is going to say her vows. And then we do the ring exchange. And so at this time, I'm going to ask Les may we please have the rings? And I'm just gonna go like this.
Well, you're last in line.
And you just have them loose in your pocket. You don't need to have them in a box or anything. Just hand them both
we'll
to me at
the
same time.
Last possible second.
Okay.
We're gonna have to write them instructions.
Just write mine on
the. And then you go first again. Okay. And so I'm gonna hand you Jennifer's ring, and you are going to pretend to put it on your finger. Okay. So, and then as you are sliding on her finger, you put it on and then you repeat after me. So you've
right.
got to hold your hand there mm-hmm. on the ring while you're repeating after me. And then when you're done, you can like make sure you got it on all the way, okay? All right, and then I'm gonna give you Jeff's ring and you're gonna put it, we do like halfway, go halfway on, and then you repeat after me and then you slide the ring all the way on. And they always stick. So don't be afraid to
have
it. Okay. And then we have a song by Brooke. This I promise you. Oh no. Whoa, I just skipped way ahead. Sorry. So we do your ring exchange and then we do our sand unity, okay? So where is the table gonna be?
I was right there. We were kind of measuring it right, I'd say. Mm-hmm. In between Jeff and I'm sorry, what's your name?
Les.
Okay.
Back here?
Well, it's, yeah. When you're kind of looking at it, it'd probably be just where you're kind of standing, it'd probably just be right over in this area.
Okay, so then we might have to shift a little bit when they go to their unity table so that the guests can see if the table's behind the wedding party.
Yep.
So we'll just kind of all shift over. I'll shift this way. You guys will go towards the table. You're gonna stand behind the table, so you're facing your guests, okay? And then I'm gonna read something first. So I'm gonna say, Jennifer and Jeff, today you join your lives together in marriage. The two separate bottles of sand are unique, distinguishable just as you. They symbolize your separate lives, separate families, and separate sets of friends. They represent all you are as individuals. They also represent your lives before today. Okay?
So we're not pouring yet.
Mm-mm.
Okay.
After I say that part, then you can start, because the next sentence I say is, as your sands come together.
Oh, okay.
As your sands come together. So that's the cue. Start pouring your sands, okay? And I'll finish that sentence, and you're gonna stay there, and I'm gonna stay over here. And we have the song. That's when Brooke is performing the song, This I Promise You.
Okay.
Yes, and when she's done, you guys walk back to where you were. I'm gonna step over, you guys are gonna step back up to where we were, okay? And we're gonna pronounce you husband and wife, right? And we're gonna have the marriage kiss, and so I think you should practice right now. What do you guys think?
I don't know.
I think they should do it again.
They need to do that again.
Let's give me some size now.
So, and actually, when you guys kiss, I get out of the way.
Okay.
So I'm not in your. I'm not in your picture.
I'm gonna be right.
Okay.
You get out of the way too.
Okay. All right.
He's so close to me, I can hear him breathe.
You can step back a little bit. I mean, you want to be at a comfortable space.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We don't give comfort.
Like Toledo, Ohio is pretty comfortable. Yeah.
Okay, so after you kiss, then Jennifer, you're going to get your flowers back. Turn the other way.
Always
and then you're
the
both going to turn and face your guests, okay? And stay here. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the newly married couple, Jennifer and Jeff. Processional music begins. Everyone cheers wildly. Jennifer, Jeff,
you
all, your wedding party stays put until
Get out of here.
Hey, Jennifer.
Jenny?
Yeah.
Do you want these guys to walk out together?
Yes.
It goes a little faster.
It's okay. a little lopsided, so like Angie and Mike walk out.
Okay. So then once they're all the way out, we can't see them anymore. You guys walk
nobody's
out the stairs,
looking
and then
up
you two
anyway.
Can go ahead.
Everybody's watching you guys.
Oh, no, actually, you're going to actually how she
was.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. You guys got it. We don't.
Yeah.
Okay, totally feel weird. It's do whatever you want.
And then that, you know,
okay, so then when they get, hey, you guys, sorry, you just wait until the same thing as when you came in.
Stand halfway.
Yeah, so when they're halfway, then you go.
I will cut you.
And you actually love me, like, yeah. When, like, you stare at your spots, and then when they're halfway, you guys meet in the center.
One
from each side of the family, because then Warren can introduce people to Kyle, which she might not have the Kyle's introduced. So it should be
Yeah, there you go.
No, it'd be Kyle.
By the way, Julie,
you, Jeff, Dad.
She goes,
that's a good idea.
Because then they were able to introduce, then you knew that all the
receiving. So that's a little easier than them introducing themselves.
It's a good tip.
And then it's not like an awkward conversation with someone you don't know because
of
the other person.
Okay, so you must be doing
Yeah. So you want to just let your friends know that I'm going to be really behind you. So less than Angie. Yeah. Okay.
Less than Angie.
Well.
Less than Angie. What did you do?
I'm innocent.
What did you do?
I'm innocent.
So after the after everybody's out, then you guys are just gonna sneak over to the silo for the
little wine.
Absolutely.
Whatever works.
Your signature does have to be like, just so you know.
Mine's not legible yet.
What? Oh, for his signature?
He made
it a little bit better.
Yeah, when Mike yelled at him.
So, okay.
Is that downstairs you're doing that, or
yeah,
upstairs?
Downstairs.
Okay.
So once we're out, we go downstairs, we set up a receiving line for the guests.
No, it's just family. Are we?
Yep. Me, Jeff, my parents, his dad. And then, but then, yes, not, and then you go to the sidewalk.
What if it's a joke? When you guys know you're done, myself, or somebody, we can grab them and say, they're right beside the mirror.
Yeah, it was like a
ninja. See the area, we're not trying that long.
For what? I'm on the payroll.
For what?
My signature.